So how did I end up doing in 2019? We're going to talk about that coming up. All right, thanks for hanging out with me today. Hey, if you're a new agent, you want to hear some tips and some advice from another new agent like myself, hit that subscribe button down below. Hey, and click that bell because I do videos every week. Now, 2019 for me was pretty crazy. I really got to see what I've been striving for, you know, since I started in the real estate business, and that was to create my own clientele, bring in my own traffic, and not pay the broker all those splits for the commissions and try to keep as much of that commission for myself. And 2019 really showed my work paying off. So today I'm gonna go over some of those numbers. This will give you some inspiration and maybe some ideas of what you can do to grow your real estate business. So as I always mention in my videos about how you can grow your business, of course it's video. It's videos like these. Put a link up there to a video, a previous video I did about making videos for a real estate agent. Videos are so important. And if you go and do a research in whatever city you live in, I don't care what state, what city, do a research, look for other real estate agents that are doing videos in your market, and I guarantee you there's very few. So it's a market that's untapped. Still today, coming into 2020, it's still untapped and there's still room for you to make videos and gain clientele. Now you also hear me talk about the no like and trust factor. This is something you can do straight from video. Now, if you're just starting out in the real estate business, you want to gain some clients. People don't know you yet, but you can get them to know you through videos like these. Yeah, so when I first started out, yes, I did. I took leads from my broker, and what I figured out there, that those splits, I wasn't always happy with those splits. I was going, man, I could make so much more money if these were my clients. So I really took that to heart and really strive to create my own business. And like I'm gonna say it over and over again, through video. Now, if you're afraid to do videos, there's other ways you can create your own business. And that's really get out and meet people. Create those relationships with people, individuals out there. Like I said, you're either gonna do it by video or you're gonna do it by meeting people in person. So get involved with your community or start getting those videos put out there and published on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, whatever platform you're comfortable with. Go for it and do it. Do it weekly, do it all the time, be consistent, and however hard you think it is, don't give up. So let's get to the point of this video, and that's what were my numbers for 2019. All right, so in 2019, I had a total of 37 both buyers and sellers. I had 18 of those were listings that I sold, and of those 18, six of them I represented both sides. So that means I had the buyers and sellers on the both sides. Somewhere in there I also had some leases. I think I had two leases for the year there. I had some off-market properties as well. But best feeling is when I did these numbers and I look and see how many leads I took from my broker. Those are leads that are that the pay-per-clicks that my broker pays for, that are brought in for the agents in our group, and only two. So of those 37, 35 were my clients. Yeah, 35 of those, all mine. So let's think about that money-wise, commission-wise, split-wise. I did a video about commission splits. So in my brokerage, if I take a lead from the broker and I sell that lead, I have to give that broker 50% of my commission. That's tough to swallow, especially when you close a big deal. You have to give 50% of that to your broker. So that was motivation for me in the beginning, not giving up that 50%. So if I don't give up that, I only have to give up 30% until I reach my cap. And once I reach my cap, I keep 100% of my commissions, and I feel so much better when I do that. So something else cool that happened in 2019 was I was able to create my own team down here in Austin, Texas. Yeah, it's about 4 hours away from our main office, but I saw the market down here and I thought, man, I want to tap into that and see what I can do down in a bigger market. So my broker trusted me. I mean, obviously I've been able to grow over these 3 years. She said, hell, why not? So here I am down here. I already have 5 agents down here. We already have things rolling down here. I've already made some contracts, some transactions down here. So I'm excited to put my, basically to start all over again in a new market. I still work 2 markets, but man, it's pretty cool. All right, so the main reason for this video is to let you know, no matter where you're at in your real estate career, there's always room to grow. So get out there, start making those videos, have an awesome 2020. Thanks for hanging out. I'll see you next time.